Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Trail Pass. So this four-wheeler in front of me is mine. I actually traded in my Can-Am Outlander 570 Max XT for, this is a used four-wheeler, but it is a Yamaha Kodiak 700. I think they have some kind of special name for this all black paint scheme and everything like that. But I wanted to go away from a two-up model back to a single seat model. Since my wife has her own four-wheeler now, we really don't need the two-up part of it. And ultimately, since I have the opportunity here on the channel to review a bunch of different four-wheelers, Yamaha is one brand I've not spent a whole lot of time with. And I got a really good deal on this one, actually, even with all the craziness with the ATV market and truck market right now. So really, really excited about this new four-wheeler. You will be seeing it a lot on the channel here coming up. A couple quick things I've done to it already. I did put some Pro Taper pillow top grips on it. I did actually take this Mad Dog seat cover off my wife's four-wheeler. Don't tell her that. And actually went ahead and put some new rubber on it as well. These are actually the Tusk Trilobite tires. Tusk is a Rocky Mountain ATV company, and they seem to be really, really great tires. They are an imitation Bighorn tire, very, very similar to the Max's Bighorn. And actually, we went ahead and got a set of Tusk tires here on my wife's C-Force as well. These are the Tusk Terraform. So these are a directional tire. Obviously, the Bighorn imitators are a non-directional tire. But overall, a really, really cool setup here. And something we'll definitely be testing here on the channel. So as you can see, it is dirty. I have been riding it and been having a great time. But one thing we are missing up here is right there. There's no winch on this machine. And if I'm going to be doing any kind of trail riding or property maintenance or anything, I think a winch is definitely the next thing we need to install. And that's what we're going to be working on here today. So my recent purchase on Amazon is a Super Winch 3,000 pound ATV winch. And actually, there was such a good deal when I was able to purchase this one. The 3,000 pound one was actually cheaper than some of the lighter weight winches. So I went ahead and sprung for that. It actually came with everything you can see here, all of the wiring, two different setups for the controls. You got handlebar mounted controls here, then also this disconnected hand control here that's on, you know, a little bit of cable there. So if you want to be off of your machine and be winching like that, you do have that option. Now, this Super Winch did come with just kind of your generic ATV winch mounting plate, but we are not going to be using that one here for this install. I actually did spring for the KFI mount. This actually is specific to the Kodiak and Grizzly 700s. So I think this should be a little bit better setup for mounting it here on the Yamaha, and should end up with a little bit better result. So did look on the Yamaha forums. They highly recommend this one, even actually over the worn plate, which is what I was looking at originally. So this KFI plate supposedly is supposed to be pretty good, but you can see it is specific for this actual machine and comes with its own directions and everything like that. So this is what we're going to be working on today. Stay tuned and hopefully we can help you out with this install. So on these newer Yamahas, the battery is actually located right under this panel. So we'll go ahead and work to get that out of the way first. So we're going to remove this front rack. It's held on in three different spots on each side. You have a 12 millimeter here, a 12 millimeter right up here, if you can see that. And actually on the other side of the fender, there's actually a 10 millimeter bolt. I'm not sure if you can see it right there, but we'll go ahead and get those out of the way and get the rack out of the way, then we can start removing some of that plastic. So once you get the rack and plastics out of the way, you're left with, in my case, a really, really dirty four-wheeler. But the battery is located right here. You can see your negative side and your positive side right there. And looks like plenty of room to route the wiring. And actually, I think it's really convenient to have the battery up front here. Now, obviously, it is not maybe the best for weight distribution, but you don't have nearly as far to run all of your cables and everything like you do on some other brands where the battery might be located under the seat. So again, the battery is right there. The winch is essentially directly below it. And that is where everything's about to get bolted up. So let's get down to it. So normally you do have two bolts that go right there in the front of your plastic skid plate. I went ahead and removed those so we can drop it down and get a little bit better look here at everything. But looking at the two different winch plates, there actually is a fair amount of difference. This one here is the one that came with the super winch. And as you can see, there's nothing wrong with it per se. It actually feels like it's made of pretty thick metal. But when it slots in here where the winch would go, there's actually nothing to mount it to. So I think you'd have to do some modifications, maybe some U-bolts or something like that. And ultimately, I think you could make it work. I think it'd be a little bit more of a process. However, when you look at the KFI plate or any other plate specific to your model, you can see it just slots right in here. It actually lines up with all the factory mounting holes. And overall, I think this is going to make for a lot cleaner install. So if you're interested in any of these products, definitely check out the description of the video and the top comment. That will direct you to where we purchased them if you want to get some for your own. So we'll go ahead and look at the directions here. And it looks like they actually want you to mount the winch and the contactor all to the plate before you put it in the machine. So we'll go ahead and get started on that. Your fair lead will mount up front. Obviously your winch sits in the middle and your contactor here should fit across the back. Now, this is for obviously a KFI winch or a Warren winch. Looks like we're gonna have to make a little bit of a bracket here just so it all slots in here. It's just a little bit different design than say the Warren or the KFI contactors, but it looks like something that we can definitely handle. So I went ahead and got everything mounted up here on the KFI winch plate. You can see I do have all the boots pulled back here. Make sure you put those boots on first because you are not getting them on after you tighten down those nuts and screws and everything else to hold it all together. But here is an idea of what it all looks like. You can see we have the wires going from the actual winch itself to the contactor. The contactor then, we got plenty of leads here to get to the battery. And here are the two for the switch. Now over here on the four-wheeler itself, I've been poking around here with my test light and found this little plug right here. It's just basically tucked in with the rest of the wires. I actually found two of them that weren't going to anything, and found that the power is going to this one that I have tapped into there. It's just powered when the switch itself is on the four-wheeler. So you don't want necessarily the handlebar switch with power all the time, just in case you're hauling it or something like that. You don't want it to accidentally be running your winch and then draining your battery. So you want to make sure you just have the keyed power. And again, that's what I found right here. You can see I tapped it in there right there, and all that is run up to the handlebars. So just a quick tip here when mounting to your handlebars, this is just the way I do it, but in and out, the way I remember that, because sometimes I have mittens or gloves or whatever else over top of my handlebars and can't really see it all, or you're, you know, say plowing snow at night or something like that, I always put in on the inside, facing the inside of the machine, and out facing the outside, the end of the handlebar. So that's just a quick way to remember it. Really, really simple there. But we are getting a little bit closer. So I think the next step is to go ahead and start mounting the winch itself onto the four-wheeler. Then we'll get the rest of the wiring done and get it all put back together. All right, guys, so I got all this way, went ahead and mocked up the winch in the winch plate and everything else, and actually even ran my red and black battery cables up here and tried it out. Everything does work just fine, but to be honest with you, I really, really hate this setup. Now, I know this is the way it was designed with the actual contactor down in here, but that's right in front of my rear diff, and obviously I could clean up those wires a little bit, but you still have the contactor and all the wires and even the small little signal wires there going to your switch. All of that is going to be down in the elements. And to be honest with you, I'm just not a huge fan of that. So I think what we're gonna try to do is take all of this back apart and locate that contactor maybe somewhere up in here. Not exactly sure yet. We'll have to see exactly how it works once we get a little closer, but yeah, I'm just not a big fan of this design. Like I said, this is exactly how it was designed to be. I'm not sure if you can see it, but the contactor is actually right in there. You might be able to see those little boots on top of it. But like I said, all of that's going to be right down there in the weather and the mud and the snow and the whatever else. And you look at the bottom of your four-wheeler and it already is muddy, dirty, and everything like that. I think you're just opening the door for a lot of corrosion. And to be honest with you, I'm not really willing to do that. So back apart it comes. All right, guys. So after many, many hours of test fitting, research on the online forums, and just overall banging my head against the wall, here's what I came up with. So I do have the winch mounted back to the plate and all of the wiring run. And as you can see, I just went ahead and zip tied it across the top there and went up here into the battery box, if you can see that. Now, what that looks like from the top is the wire comes right through this little bit of a vent here into the battery box. Now, I went ahead and made a bracket here, more about that in a second, and tucked all my wires up here against the steering column. Honestly, kind of a mess, but it's the best thing I could come up with to keep all of this out of the elements. So what this was able to let me do is to mount my solenoid and my circuit breaker. I wrapped the circuit breaker there in electrical tape just to keep it from grounding out on something else. But I was able to mount that all up and out of the way. And I made this little bracket that mounted it into the existing, I don't know what you want to call that. This is normally the tank area, but obviously on these Yamahas, it's just storage. But where this top piece mounts together, you got a bolt on each side. And I used one of those for my bracket. Now, here is the bracket that I retrofitted. Actually, this is to mount a flat screen TV on the wall, but it was one of the leftover pieces when you get one of those kits. But basically, I just bent it right on the side here, right about in there, made a 90 degree angle, and you can see it comes across through the back of this, and that is where I mounted my solenoid. So again, this allows it all to be up and out of the way. Now, what took so long about this process is just trying to get all these wires bundled up. Obviously, they send way, way more wire than what you need, especially when your battery is right here and your solenoid is right here. So I do have all of it mounted to the handlebars. It comes down behind my third headlight here, and there's the rest of my wires for the controller. Then, like I said, there's my circuit breaker, my solenoid, and like I said, we just kind of bunched all these up and tucked them here under the intake tube. And overall, again, I know it's not the prettiest, but it will stay a lot more out of the elements. So if you would decide to mount it down here, obviously this is the way that the plate was designed. You're supposed to be able to mount it all right in here, if you can see the tip of my finger, but all of that would be down in the elements. This is a lot more out of the elements, but it doesn't look really nice. But thankfully, the hood piece does go right over top of this. So let's go ahead and test fit that, and we'll get it all put back together. Now, one other tip before you put all of this back together. Under all these little boots, I did put a dab of dielectric grease. That will help to keep all those contacts really clean, hopefully out of the mud, water, debris that we might find out on the trail. So that should help protect the longevity of this as well. All right, guys, so we got everything buttoned up here, and here is a look at the finished product. And overall, I am super happy that I went this route. I got a great deal on the Super Winch winch itself, and from the reviews I've been reading, it looks like it is a really great product. We definitely went overkill with the 3,000 pound winch, but that means we shouldn't be taxing it very hard and should last a really, really long time. So overall, would I recommend going this route again? And the answer is kind of complicated, to be honest with you. Yamaha does make the four-wheelers a little bit different to where you do need a winch plate. And for me, the generic one just wasn't the answer. I really didn't like this. I wanted something a little bit more beefy, and I wanted something that overall was made for the machine. And I think that's where the KFI winch plate really, really came in handy. So it mounted up perfectly to the Super Winch, and overall, no complaints with that. The major complaint that I have is just that Yamaha doesn't really have a great spot to mount the stuff underneath the hood, let's see. You know, all the wires and everything that we just showed, it doesn't really look all that good. And, you know, I might be a little bit of a perfectionist, and I don't mind making little brackets and those sort of things, but that is kind of my only complaint with the whole deal. Now, I'm sure somebody in the comments will have a great idea of where I could have done that. And, you know, overall, I might move it later. But, you know, this is kind of the best thing I've come up with. Now, obviously, if you don't have one of these little brackets laying around, you could just as easily make one yourself out of a little strap of metal, or even zip tied in place if you so choose. That's not really the major deal with this. But overall, I think, you know, it should last for a really long time. Again, the fit and finish of the plate and the super winch itself are really, really nice. The only shoddy part is my handiwork itself. So let me know what you all think. Let me know if you would have mounted the solenoid down there on the actual winch plate itself, or if you think I was better off by mounting up high and out of the way of all that grime. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And again, if you have any suggestions that might help out some other folks, they're in the process of mounting their own winch, definitely leave that in the comment section. So thank you all very much for watching. Have a fantastic week, everybody. We'll catch you next time.